It's a visit to Eoghan's Corner for some good old-fashioned abuse.
Yes, indeed. I lured them up under false pretenses. I said chocolate would be here, but abuse it shall be. Coaches, you're very welcome. Last week on the show with the contestants, we did Never Have I Ever. You guys escaped unscathed, but that shall be resolved right here, right now. Never Have I Ever, paddles at the ready. All that we ask is you be completely honest.
And smack Brezzy in the face.
Well, that's optional at the end. We're trying to pull away from the violence tonight, Keegan. It's been a bit full on. Right, here we go. Never Have Ever. First up,
tennis.
Never have I ever snogged a fan.
Fan.
Have you ever snogged a fan?
Have you ever snogged a fan? Jamelia!
Jamelia!
Oh, you dirty pervert.
Yeah, but I'm just thinking, if someone goes out with you, they kind of only knew you because they were a fan.
Did you, like, totally suck their face? Like,
no, it wasn't like a fan, like, waiting outside, but just, you know...
Well, you know what to do tonight, Eoghan. Wait outside Jamelia's dressing room, you might
Jamelia,
be able to...
Jamelia, I am such a fan. I am such a massive fan. So
that's
we can...
No,
now we've got... Okay.
I don't mean like... Oh,
too late.
Okay,
Moving on. Have you ever told someone... Have you ever told someone their bum didn't look big in an outfit when it clearly did?
No. You can say that.
Keegan has. Okay, we're just going to move on from that one. That's slightly awkward. Are you talking about your wife?
No, definitely not. My wife has got a great bum.
Okay, good to know. Never have I ever trashed a hotel room.
Oh, no.
You all have? Dolores, after hear this one, which hotel are you trashing?
No, it was in New Zealand last year, and no, seriously, it wasn't long after my dad died, and I was on tour, and I was kind of depressed, and I was sitting on the patio, and I was drinking wine, and suddenly I realised I was getting too drunk, and I had to work tomorrow, so I put a spud into the microwave, and I couldn't reach up, so I couldn't see what I was turning it on to, so I think I put it on for like an hour, and then I went back out in the patio, and then I looked down, and there was like fire brigades downstairs, and I was going, what's going on? And I was kind of looking over at the beach thinking, what's going on here? Where's the fire brigades? Next thing, boom, in the door. Just like that, boom. A load of lads, fire brigades with the pump and all.
Okay, I'm scared, please. You're scaring me. You're roaching.
Genuine mistake, like, you know, but the spud, my husband come running out the back room, right? My son's in the other room. And the spud, he takes it out, right? And the spud was like a meteor. It was actually red, like a bit of coal out the fire. I mean, go figure. Did you even know, like, that spuds could turn into meteors, right? So he comes running out, right? No, check it out, right? So I'm out in the balcony, and I'm kind of thinking, Jesus, what's all the noise? All the commotion? Having me fagged. Next thing, he comes running out, and he throws the spud into my wine thing. Speaks. And I'm like, what happened? He was like, go to bed. Seriously.
Can we have a round of applause for Dolores, everybody? Come on. We'll hear more about this story in the after party, don't worry. We're also on live television, so let's... All answers must be under 7 minutes. Never have I ever stolen anything. Ah, Brezzy, I got to come to you. You look like a little shoplifter.
A shoplifter? I used to
He's from Mullingar.
Whoa.
Quickly.
It's a joke. I used to rob the tuck shop I used to work in school. We weren't getting paid for it. We got like a cup of oxtail soup at like the end of the
That's not rock and roll.
Well, bars, Rider Rover bars, you name it, I was robbing them.
Okay, one question I have to, a serious question. Someone says, in fact it's Sarah, former contestant, tweeted in to say, the stench of tactical scoring from the coaches is pugnant. A six cannot be justified for Jamie.
Is that for me?
It's for anybody, take the floor, Keith.
Listen, it's very simple. I'm not trying to score Jamie down.
Yeah.
It's very simple. When you compare, it's a very important scenario when our points have got an awful lot to do who goes through to the next part of the show. You've got to compare the...
Okay, no, yeah, this is what you said on stage.
So,
yeah.
What I'm saying is, if Brezzy is going to give someone like Jay a 7,
yeah.
And in my opinion, if Brezzy had given Jay an 8, I probably would have given Jamie an 8.
Okay, no.
We're
going to continue this a little bit later. I think the overwhelming thing we've learned here is don't put a spud in the microwave, Catherine.